Elhamdülillah. Ve salatu ve selam. Ala Resulillah ve ala Ali ve sahibi ecmain. Amma ba'd. Euzu billahi mineşşeytanirracim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ve kul ca'al hak ve zakil batil. İnnel batile kâne zahuka. Nezulü minel Kur'an ma huve şifaun rahmetil mu'minin. Ve la yezidu zalimin illa khasara. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Rabbi şrahli sadri. Ve yessirli amri. Ve hallul ugdatan min lisani. Yafkahu kavli. The respected people on the dais, and my respected elders, and my dear brothers and sisters, I welcome once again all of you with Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, mercy, and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. I have not conveniently forgotten anything. If you realize I spoke maybe half minute more than the time allotted, so how can you say I conveniently forgot? If you give me even 5 hours more, if you're willing to stay, because you are the person who kept time restrictions, you know, less time 30. I had to bargain for 15 minutes. I would love to speak for 2 hours, even full day. I can do it because I'm a marathon speaker. Alhamdulillah. I'm a non-vegetarian. Mr. Zaveri said that I said that no religion prohibits non-veg. I never said no religion. I said no major religion. It's being recorded. No major religion. And Jainism is not a major religion. According to the books you gave me, you gave certain books, Jain is only 0.4% of India, 0.4. Less than 1%. Can you call it a major religion? In India, leave aside world. World out of the question. Negligible. I am very clear on my statement. Regarding the argument on Jainism, I can reply, but the coordinator won't give me permission. I'm restricted to Islam, you know. I can reply even on Jainism. I'm a student of comparative.
Excuse me, sir. You can't interfere when the speaker is speaking.
Brother is saying, I did not say. You can very well see the video cassette. There is not a single major religion which bans or prohibits all non-veg food in general. You can see the video cassette.
Ask your question in question time, please.
Don't get irritated. The diet will help you. Don't get irritated. Brother Rashmi Bhai Zaveri said, I did not answer whether you get animal instinct. I said in my lecture, I think you didn't hear. I said we eat peaceful animals like goat, sheep, because we want to be peaceful. And therefore when I came starting, I always said, peace be on all of you. Further, he said, I didn't state Dr. Dean Ornish. I yet challenge him. If his book is referred by any authentic medical college, authentic book, not just dietary books. That answer already gave by Dr. William T. Jarvis. Even scientists and medical professionals are not immune to the ideological thinking of the vegetarians. They aren't immune. It's not a medical book. He may have written a diet book. I am very clear in my words. I don't mix words. And Dean Ornish, whatever his name is, may be very famous. I don't know him. I'm hearing him for the first time. I don't know. I yet ask him to prove and check whether that book is referred as a textbook. Not as a medical book, a text medical book in a college. That shows authenticity. He said, we should not worry about the cattle. Nature will take care. It is you all who are so much worrying. We aren't worrying. Nature made them in such a way that the moment you kill them, they will again come. God is the creator. Allah made them. If we kill lion, tiger, they will become extinct. Therefore, we cannot have their food. The cattle, we can have. God has made them that way. If we don't follow the instruction of God, there will be overpopulation. And regarding cutting of plants, what he said, you know, people say that if you have plants, the mother is yet alive. So in that way, the offspring of the cow, of the goat, the calves, that means can we cut them? Yes. The mother is yet alive. The cow is yet alive. And when the offspring becomes a mother, you can also kill the mother. So even if I agree with this logic, the plant survives. In the animals, more lives are surviving than the plants, if I agree with the logic. Furthermore, I said that best is prevention is better than cure. I agree with Dr. Ornish when he says that, you know, vegetarian diet is helpful for certain diseases. Even I advise that. Well, I said no. But the topic is not which food is healthier, but making a statement, it is banned for human beings. I challenge any authentic medical book. I'm a doctor, not books. Whether given by Russia Foundation or Indian Vegetarian Congress, whatever it is, these books are stating things which are unfound, ill-tested, unproved. There is an Islamic method of prevention better than cure, which will answer most of your questions. The Islamic method is there of prevention better than cure. When we slaughter the animal, we do the zabiha. We cut the throat and the windpipe and the vessels of the neck without damaging the spinal cord. Otherwise, the nerve going to the heart may get severed, there may be cardiac arrest. When the spinal cord is not damaged and the vessels of the neck are slit open along with the throat and the windpipe, the heart is pumping, most of the blood flows out of the body. Blood is a very good media of germ and bacteria. If you slaughter the animal in this way, most of the disease transmitted by blood, many which you named, can be eliminated, can be prevented. The meat remains fresh for a longer time if it's slaughtered with the Islamic method. And people say, oh, it's a merciless. No, you all are so mercilessly killing, it dies of pain. When we slaughter in the Islamic method, when we cut the blood vessels of the neck, the blood supply going to the nerve, which is responsible for pain, is severed. So the animal does not feel pain. The animal kicks and writhes. You know why? Due to the gush of flow. The animal doesn't feel pain. It is contracting and relaxing because there's lack of blood in that part of the body. The animal does not die of pain. It dies a painless death. Painless. Painless. We eliminate most of the disease transmitted by blood. Secondly, there are many countries in the world and many people who raise animals, they give them hormones. And one was mentioned by Mr. Zaveri, the name. It's called as DES, diacetylbisterol. It's a hormone injected to cattle so that they become fat and you get more money for flesh. This is haram in Islam. Carcinogenic hormones, if ingested in animal, even if you slaughter by the zabiha method, it is yet haram. It is zabiha but not halal. It is zabiha and haram. If the cattle are injected with hormones, you are not allowed to have those hormones. Neither are we allowed to have cows which are fed with non-veg. Because the Prophet said, any animal that is fed with non-veg, it is prohibited for you. After that, if you take care of hygienic conditions and cook the meat very well, most of the diseases which Mr. Zaveri spoke, or not all, most of them will be eliminated. And in the non-veg flesh food, the most dangerous, which is commonly eaten, is pork. It has more than 70 different diseases which you can get if you ingest pork. More than 70 different diseases. And one of them is ischemic heart disease, which he spoke about. Because pork has more of fat building material than muscle building material, it gets deposited on the walls of the vessels, causing atherosclerosis, hypertension, etc. That's the reason in the Quran, no less than 4 different places, in Surah Baqarah chapter number 2 verse number 173, in Surah Maidah chapter number 5 verse number 3, in Surah An'am chapter number 6 verse number 145, and Surah Nahl chapter number 16 verse number 115, it says, حُرِّمَتْ عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَيْتُتُ وَالدَّمُ وَلَحْمُ الْخِنْزِيرِ وَمَا أُهِلَّ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ بِهِ. Forbidden for you for food are dead meat, blood, the flesh of swine, and any food on which any name besides God's name has been invoked. It's haram. So we abstain from it and we prevent several diseases of non-veg. Quran says in Surah Taha, chapter number 20, verse number 81, eat of the food we have provided for you in sustenance, but commit no excesses therein. Most of the diseases, what Mr. Rashmi Bhai Zaveri spoke about, is due to excessive eating. Even if you eat excessive veg food, you will have many diseases. I will not say, don't have veg food. I'm a doctor. I'm not an ideological, neither a fanatic non-vegetarian. So if you prevent eating in excess, most of the disease will be prevented. If you follow the Islamic guidelines, slaughter in the Islamic method, remove the blood, don't give hormones, cook the food very well, hygienic conditions, avoid pork, don't eat in excess, most of the disease can be prevented. It answers most of the arguments. Few are yet remaining. If time permits or during question answer time, if you ask, I will reply. Do you know that talking about healthy food, talking about all research and experiments, I'll talk something which is a fact. According to Dr. William, again, very famous person, Dr. William, he says that vegetarian food extends the life of a human being for more than 6 years. If you have veg food, as compared to non-veg food, you live 6 years longer. Again, hypothesis.